Hi there, and welcome to the last day of our course, The Seven Rules of Adept English. Well done, you made it through to Rule 7. You're showing that you're persistent, you're good at keeping going, at continuing, and this is exactly what you need to learn a language. So, we're coming to the end, but I'm pleased that I can offer you the opportunity to keep learning with me. This doesn't need to be the end of your learning with Adept English. So let's move on to Rule 7. Rule 7 is just as important as the other rules. In fact, it's so important it's given its name to the whole system of learning, which is Adept English. So Rule 7 says, learn adeptly. The word adept means very skilled or proficient at something, accomplished or expert at it. So you could be adept at riding a bike, adept at mathematics, or adept at playing the piano. So the aim is for you to become adept at understanding and speaking in English. The aim is for it to become an automatic skill. But the word adept in this context also means that the method of learning is effective and efficient. Adept means that you're not taking the long way round to learning a language. You don't need to take years to learn a language. And this shows in the way that the courses are structured and designed. So Rule 7, learn adeptly, also means that this is a quicker, more intelligent way to learn a language. The Adept English method of learning English doesn't go the long way round. It takes shortcuts to get you to your goal. So Adept also means the way that the courses are written and structured. It's estimated that the 100 most commonly used words in English make up about 50%, half of conversation. This course expects you to already know the 100 most used words, but if you don't know them all yet, you'll get plenty of opportunity to learn them here. And gradually, I introduce more and more words bit by bit so that your vocabulary has the chance to grow naturally. But there are no vocabulary lists here. There's no learning verbs. You pick it up as you go along. And if you respect the way that your brain works, you learn more adeptly. It's well known that learning something new, initially you begin by working really hard to do it. But with practice, the learning and the skill starts to live in the automatic part of your brain. So you can do it without thinking about it. You know how it is if someone asks you a question about grammar in your own language. You know the answer, but sometimes you have to think about it because you just automatically apply the rules. You're adept at your own language. Imagine how great it would be to understand and speak English in this way too. Adept English is also adept because it makes sure that you're listening to English as it's really spoken, with idioms, real-life conversations, and phrases which are in use all the time. It's genuine, authentic English. With Adept English, you don't find a big difference between what you hear in the classroom, on your language course, and real life. Here, it's all real life. The English that you hear in Adept English courses and podcasts is already the same as you'll hear in the street, in the cafe, in the pub, from real English speakers. If you don't use authentic English as it is really spoken, then you're going to have problems when you try to watch an English film, or when you try to join in a conversation with English speakers. It's no good learning classroom English and then expecting yourself to make that big jump right at the end. You need to be listening to genuine, authentic English all along. Remember, traditional language courses also have other problems. They give equal attention to reading, writing, speaking, and listening. You become good at passing exams, but that doesn't mean that you are fluent. It doesn't mean that you're good at English conversation. So, Adept English focuses on the part of learning which you really need to be able to understand and speak fluently. Fluent means it flows like a liquid. So you need to move away from translating. You need to think fluently in English. So Adept English focuses on listening and understanding because these are critically important if you want to become a fluent speaker of English. So the English you learned at school or the English that you learned on your college course gives you a good base. But if you want to speak fluently, you need to have a source of authentic English to listen to. And you need to have an Adept system, an Adept method for learning it. Adept English provides these for you. Adept English gives you the opportunity to hear a lot of spoken English, just as though you were living in an English-speaking country. It's also good for keeping your English fresh, up to date, if you can already speak it, but you don't get to practice it very often. Much of what I teach you, you won't find in a grammar book, or in a dictionary, or on a traditional language course. So be smart, learn adeptly, and let us help you to improve your English. If you use the advice that I've given you in the 7 rules, if you apply these rules to your language learning, whether you're learning English or whether you're learning another language, you will succeed. All the courses and the podcasts respect the 7 rules. All the courses and the course material is based on listening, on improving your understanding, just like it says in Rule 1 of Adept English. Everything is also based on repeating your listening, which is Rule 2. You can listen as many times as you like to the podcasts and the recordings from the courses, and I encourage you to do so. The courses also respect Rule 3. Do your learning when you're doing other things. Every piece of material, whether it's a course or a podcast, comes as an MP3 file so that you can download it. You can copy it across to your phone or your tablet and listen in the car, on the bus, while you're exercising, while you're doing those boring jobs in the house. In fact, wherever you go, ensure that you've got some Adept English with you in case you get delayed, and then you can always use the time. Every piece of Adept English has a PDF file so that you always have the written words with you too. You can use these if you need them. Sometimes they're enough, and sometimes you may find you need to use the dictionary as well. The courses all respect Rule 4. Be kind to yourself. Don't do self-criticism. You can progress at your own pace. Think of how you're improving little by little every time you listen to another recording. You're getting close to that point where your brain remembers all the words. Little by little, week by week, you improve. How fantastic is that? The courses and podcasts respect Rule 5, nothing but English. Everything is explained in English so that we get you to think in English and we take you away from translating. Remember, translating is the enemy of fluency. and we aim to encourage there to be an English part of your brain. Rule 5 also says respect the way that your brain wants to learn, and it wants to learn through context. You allow your brain to hear a new word in context 30 times and it will do the rest. Your brain will then supply that word automatically when you want to use it in a conversation. So on our courses, I ensure that the new words that I've introduced are used again in the story section for each group of lessons. I try to create an image, a picture in your head of the word in context so that you can remember it. And Rule 6, the helping hand, is woven through all of our courses and podcasts. I give you special help, like a tutorial one-to-one, on the things that you are likely to find difficult. On Course 1, Activate Your Listening, I give you opportunity to hear different people speaking English, along with the vocabulary explanation and a PDF file for each one, which is preparing you all the time for English conversation. And finally, Rule 7. Rule 7 says, learn adeptly, focus on becoming fluent and on thinking in English. If you use the right method and listen to authentic English, it doesn't need to take years to start speaking a language. So now you come to an important decision. Are you going to go further with this? Are you going to learn English just like you learned your own language? Are you going to use this new natural method of learning a language? It's not magic, but it's based on how your brain works, how your brain expects to learn after thousands of years of learning language. You've seen this possibility now. Do you really want to go back to your old way of learning English? If you follow the instructions for my courses, and if you keep at it, I guarantee that your English language skills will improve. Have a look at the course page on our website. Read the descriptions of the courses. Read about how they work. If you have questions about the courses or the course material, you can contact me and ask them. You can start by buying Course 1, Activate Your Listening. If you buy the course, I don't think that you will regret it. I think that you will be very pleased that you took this step and bought our course. It's also risk-free. We give you a money-back guarantee anyway, and we do that because we are confident that the courses will be right for most people. So, thank you very much for letting me be your teacher for the 7 Rules of Adept English. And I look forward to working with you some more. Goodbye.